Krishna everyone, this is Srinivas. I'm here to talk about the Seemantha Samskara. Would you like to know what is Seemantha? Well, I have tried to document this beautiful tradition that has been existing in the Sanatan culture since time immemorial. Do watch this video to know more about it.
Seemantham process, first is the Vigneshwar Puja. In Sri Brahma Samhita 5.50, it says that Yat Pada Pallava Yugam Vinidhaya Kumbha Dvandve Pranama Samaye Saganadhi Raja Vignan Vihantum Alamasya Jagatrayasya Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. And the translation, I adore the primeval Lord Govinda, whose lotus feet are always held by Ganesha upon the pair of tumuli protruding from his elephant head, in order to obtain power for his function of destroying all the obstacles on the path of progress of the three worlds. That's why we do always the Vigneshwar Puja in the starting.
Govinda Madhu, to that Govinda, I worship that Govinda, right? So, and who is the remover of obstacles in the spiritual world? Which form of Govinda does that? Narasimhadev, the remover of the ultimate obstacle, which is Hiranyakashipu, right? Towards the ultimate devotee, who is Prahlad Maharaj. So he is the one who removes the obstacle in the spiritual world, and that power is given to Ganeshji to remove the obstacles in the material world. So this is why it starts with offering prayers to Ganeshji.
Second process is Sankalpa. Traditionally, before performing any work, we undertake Sankalpa, which is a kind of declaration to ourselves and to the manifestation of God within us, that is, Paramatma. The Veda says that whole universe is evolved through a Sankalpa of Lord Narayana. In practical terms, a Sankalpa means a one-pointed resolve to focus both psychologically and philosophically on a specific goal. A Sankalpa is a tool meant to refine the will and to focus and harmonize mind and body. Sankalpa is performed by sitting in Padmasana, by clasping the right palm over the left, rested on the right thighs near the knee. After chanting Sankalpa mantra, usually some flowers and rice taken in the right hand palm are dropped in the Arghya Patra using water. Third process is Punyaha Vachanam. This involves cleansing the house, purifying it by performing Ganapati Puja, Kalasha Puja and chanting the mantras to invoke the power in the water. This purified water is sprinkled especially everywhere in the house or the place where this ritual is performed. The mother-to-be is bathed with this sanctified water into which powerful Vedic mantras have been invoked. Next is the recitation of Pancha Shanti, which is also called as Shanti Panchakam. This is a set of five Shanti mantras that are traditionally chanted, typically during a Vedic ceremony to invoke peace and purity. Next is Agnikaryam. The Agnikaryam is dedicated to and named after the god of fire, Agni. The fire of the Agnikaryam is conceptualized as a cosmic element during the performance of the rite. It is featured in the text Saraswati Suktam. The Agnikaryam is performed with the help of samets or small wooden sticks or twigs, usually of arali tree.
Which is the process of offering yajna. It is the fire ritual that is performed, where the fire that is lit in front of you, that represents the mouth of Lord Vishnu. And everything that you're offering, you offer to the mouth of Lord Vishnu.
Yahoma, also known as Havan, is a fire ritual performed on special occasions by a Vedic priest, usually for a grihasa. The fire is the agent, and the offerings include those that are material and symbolic, such as grains, ghee, milk, incense, and seeds.
Okay.
Next one is Pumsavana and Seemantha Vaibhavam. This is a combined performance of the two Hindu rites of Pumsavana and Seemantonayana. Both form a part of the prenatal rituals, part of samskara in the Hindu tradition. These rituals are observed in India by the pregnant mother and father of the child during a specific month of pregnancy, as followed traditionally in their family as a parampara. The specific materials used during the samskara specific to the mother are the quill of a porcupine, an ear of ripe paddy, and some udumbara leaves. Their implications are that the pregnancy should be fruitful, the child should be endowed with sharp and penetrating intellect like the sharp quill of the porcupine. After this, music, especially on the veena, is played. This increases the mother's ability to breastfeed efficiently, besides conferring other psychological benefits.
I would request Bhavya and my team over here on the stage to join with me in chanting of the holy names of Sri Mahavishnu, that is Vishnu Sahasranam.
Jayam Stuman Namasyam Sejanastame Vacha Anadinidanam Vishman Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Lokadyaksham Stuman Nityam Sarvadukkhadigo Bhavet Brahmanyam Sarvadharmanyam Lokanam Kirtivardhanam Lokanatam Mahabhutam Sarvabhutabhavodbhavam Yeshame Sarvadharmanam Dharmodikatamo Matah Yadbhaktya Pundarikaksham Stavairachenarasada Paramamyo Mahatteja Paramamyo Mahattapah Paramam Yomam Brahma Paramam Yaparayanam Pavitranam Pavitram Yomam Galanam Chamangalam Dvaivatam Devatanam Chamudanam Yogyanapita Yagasarvani Bhutani Bharatyadi Yugagame Yasmins Chakrayam Yanti Kudareva Yugakshaye Tasya Loka Pradhanasya Jagannathasya Bhupate Vishno Nama Sahasram Neshuna Papa Bhayapaham Yani Namani Gaunani Vikhyatani Mahatmanaha Rishibhih Parihitani Tani Lakshyami Bhutaye Rishim Nam Nam Sahasrasya Veda Vyaso Mahamunihi Chando Nushtukta Kadevo Bhagavan Devaki Sutaha Amritam Shuddha Bobijam Shakti Devaki Nandanaha Usamahadayam Tasya Shantya Devini Yujjate Raha Shankarindranjati Chakri Dihi Latham Shankaram Vakadadara Ityasram Ratham Vapani Rakshogya Iti Nitram Trisama Samarasam Iti Kavacham Anandam Parabrahmi Iti Yonihi Jnanam Shirodham Vapradeshe Shuchinam Vila Satsaitate Maktikanam Mala Tutta Samastas Patikamani Bhair Maktikai Manditam Daha Shubhraya Praya Tabhraya Vapadirajitai Mukta Inno Samarashai मुकुन्दः भूपादौ शिष्य नागर्वीयज सुवर्णश्चन्द्र सूर्यौ च नेत्रे कर्णाशाशिरोद्यौन्मुखमनिरहमो यस्य वास्तेयमर्तिः अन्तस्थं यस्य विश्वं सुरनरकलगोभोगन्धर्वदैत्यैः
They make the experience for this child as least troublesome as possible. May the child have the best of the upbringing and spiritual life as it grows. And may the child contribute as much as possible to society.
While we endeavor to continue following these Vedic samskaras, we do know that it is difficult to perform them faultlessly with complete perfection. This is why in the age of Kali, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has bestowed upon us the summum bonum of all Vedic sacrifices, which is the Yuga Dharma of Kali Yuga, the chanting of the holy name Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Therefore, we did a congregation chanting of 108 times this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, which is one round of chanting, which is the most powerful mantra to invoke the blessings of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
And who says that traditions cannot be fun? The puja and rituals at home were followed by a spiritually conscious cultural event with our friends and family, which made this day even more memorable for all of us. This was yet another example of how keeping God in the center enriches every experience.
So let's see what is the surprise. Unique to see how we are experiencing this in Netherlands.
Oh,
Life cannot be made from chemicals, but only by the grace of God. A child in the womb is able to hear everything that is going around through the ears of the mother. Therefore, it is very important to ensure that the mother listens to auspicious sound vibrations during her pregnancy. By Krishna's mercy, we have been observing that the child in Sindhya's womb has a special liking to one specific bhajan and responds prominently to make this liking known to everyone time and again.
Just a humble attempt to pay our respects to the richness of Sanatan culture. Understanding the true significance of our traditions makes us realize the scientific and spiritual aspect behind every ritual. And the responsibility lies on our shoulders to pass on these values to the next generation for a better tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Hare Krishna.